Okay, welcome back to Let's Play Dwarf Fortress. I've decided that before we go ahead and keep this migrant wave going, we need to get the military in so that I know which ones are military and which ones aren't. Otherwise, I have to look through them all again. And so, our wood burner here, our skilled marks dwarf, competent armor user, competent dodger, is going to become our militia commander. So, we may rename him later on dwarf names, which I'll probably do later on in this video. But for now, we want to escape out of here. Keep it paused. Don't unpause it. Put him in the manager spot. We'll say woodburner. There you go. Okay. Now, along with him... It changed his sprite, too. That's nice. Or her. Why do I keep calling it him? Yeah, anyway. Along with her, okay, Aban here is also going into the military. So, need to go to the military menu, which is the fun part that people hate. First thing you gotta do is get a military commander. That's what Azamel was. So, now we need to create a squad. I would go ahead and put this at no uniform at this point. And since we only have the militia commander, she goes in as the first slot. So then, we have to go down here, move over to the squad positions, the tongs of paddling. I'm not going to comment on that. Then we want to get Aban, add them in here. What else do after Aban? Azamel, Aban. I guess we want Erst. Mace Dwarf, Arx Dwarf in there. So go down there. Tongs of paddling. Third spot. Gonna be Erst. Now they won't train, they won't really act as military just yet. Right now it's just acting as a placeholder. So let's go ahead and let the wave continue. Looks like another woodworker. Oh, who's that? So, woodworker is his actual bower and a swords dwarf. They're definitely going in the military. Stackud, cavern, whatever. So, Stackud, bower. And then the next dwarf. Thinking medical dwarf? It's a surgeon. Wow. We know what we're a novice comedian, too. But the first surgeon we get, I plump helmet. Plump helmet. Right. Well, it'll be the chief medical dwarf. Oh, brain is taking vacation all of a sudden. Okay, preferences layer, make sure we have all healthcare set. And then we want to put in the nobles, chief medical dwarf. Plump helmet. And it's a he this time, actually. Last time it was a she. So, let's see. Hair is crinkly. Pretty short. Neatly combed. Long beard. Tangled teeth. Angular chin. Somewhat short ears. There's just that skin is a dark peach. He's very flimsy. Okay. He detests cave spiders. His poor memory. Natural ability with music. And good to focus. Well, that's good. Cracks easily under pressure. That's not so good. He's not going out of his way to help others. Okay. His voice trails off whenever he tries to remember something. Yeah, that sounds vaguely familiar. A la 30 seconds ago. And then the last creature we had coming in is a stray horse. Owned by nobody. When they aren't owned, at least we can butcher them. Toss them in the pit. So, let's go see what else we got here. I assume it's another animal coming out. Looked like it was the last one. Plump Helmet had a puppy. Okay. And that looks like the end of that migrant wave. So, from 7 up to 16, we more than doubled their amount of dwarves. But this... Well, most of them will become military. The ones that I put in there, we've got... good 4. I think that's probably good for 16. So, to do this, we need a barracks. So, let's get back over here. Everybody clusters around the stairs in the one meeting hall. I'm going to place a bed in here. Put it over there for the heck of it. Hey, a little bit. We'll put a couple beds, actually. Just random placements. And how are we doing on digging before all this came? With the extra dwarves, it should get that stone moving nicely. And a new mason. Oh, that reminds me. We can take Acleon off masonry, which wasn't really his... Even though he's a novice mason, we can take that off of him. Give him engraving that he wanted on his character. And we can assign that room to him. I'll assign the chair to Acleon. And then we go in here, go down to the bookkeeper. And so we wanted settings. We want to bring up the precision. I usually just go up to the highest. I mean, it leaves him sitting in there working on the books forever and ever. But... gives him skill, and we won't need him for a while for engraving. So, need to get our manager an office. Guess we'll go ahead and build that now. Should be able to. Put that there. And let's start doing that. Let's go ahead and make some more beds. Make a full 10 beds for all of our... We've only got, what, 9 dwarves? Designate, get some trees cut outside. Let's cut inside of our palisade area here, just to be certain. And gather plants, too. I don't think there's many plants running around here, but maybe a few. There's some. More than I expected, actually. And we need to put those new animals in the pit. Let's see. Set pit information. Maybe those 3 at the bottom. Okay. Alrighty then. Well, they're running about, doing their thing, picking some plants. Let's get another wall set up so that our new mason can prove his worth. That like that. Uh-huh. Looks like we're finally getting a good amount of claystone to use. We'll wait until that tree gets cut down for that end. And that's all for this episode, so I shall see you next time, and I will update any extra dwarf names that I don't have.